Russia's advanced stealth fighter jet, Sukhoi Su-57, wowed the audience at Aero India 2025, showcasing its stealth, speed, and maneuverability. As Russia's first fifth-generation fighter jet, the Su-57 was the highlight of the event. Sergey Bogdan, honored test pilot and hero of Russia, flew the Su-57E at Aero India 2025, introducing the updated flight program. The Aero India 2025 air show was held from February 10th to 14th at the Yelahanka Air Force Base in Bangalore. Born on April 21, 1966, in Novosibirsk, Russia, Sergey Bogdan graduated from the Yeysk Higher Military Aviation School in 1988 and began testing advanced aircraft at the Gromov Flight Research Institute. Bogdan has tested many aircraft, including the MiG-29, Su-30, and Su-35. He was also one of the first pilots to fly the T-50, the predecessor of the Su-57. During its maiden flight on January 29, 2010. In 2017, Bogdan was awarded the title Hero of Russia for his work in testing and developing new aircraft systems in extreme conditions. Bogdan has showcased Russian aviation internationally, including at the Zhuhai Air Show 2024 in China, where he flew the Su-57E. At Aero India 2025, Bogdan presented the latest flight program for the Su-57E, showcasing the aircraft's maneuverability, stealth technology, and defense ties between Russia and India. A prototype flight demonstrator of Russia's Su-57E stealth fighter aircraft landed at Yelahanka Air Base in Bengaluru on February 6 to participate in Aero India 2025. Visitors to Aero India can also fly the Su-57E's interactive simulator, which incorporates virtual reality elements. The Sukhoi Su-57, NATO reporting name, Felon, is a fifth-generation multi-role fighter aircraft designed to engage air, ground, and sea targets. It incorporates stealth technology through extensive use of composite materials and can reach supersonic cruise speeds. It can perform both air superiority and precision strike missions. The Su-57 has a low radar cross-section and reduced infrared and electro-optical emission signatures, allowing it to operate stealthily. Its design emphasizes frontal stealth with radar-suppressing features. Equipped with advanced radio-electronic equipment, including advanced computers, the Su-57's radar system is spread throughout its body, and its weapons are housed inside the fuselage. The AI system takes over some of the pilot's functions, including piloting and preparing for weapons use. The Su-57 can be armed with long-range missiles and two short-range missiles for air-to-air combat missions. The Su-57 uses the K-77 Izdalai 180 active radar as its main medium-range missile and can also integrate the R-37M long-range hypersonic missile. The Su-57 has a maximum speed of over Mach 2 and allows for better maneuverability in combat situations. Its aerodynamics and engines allow it to fly supersonic without afterburners at Mach 1.3, with a supersonic range of over 1,500 kilometers. The Su-57's maiden flight is an indication of growing defense collaboration between Russia and India, which have a long history of military partnership, including joint aircraft production. The Su-57 promises to bring cutting-edge technology to India's defense landscape, offering a glimpse into the future of air combat. India becomes the second country where Russia will showcase its Su-57E stealth fighter, the first being at the China International Aviation and Aerospace Exhibition in Zhuhai in November 2024. Russia showcased two Su-57s at the air show, one performed an aerial demonstration, while the other was displayed statically. In the early stages of the PAC-FA program, India planned to become one of the largest foreign customers by purchasing the FGFA derivative. Initially, India planned to purchase 166 single-seat and 48 twin-seat fighters, but later changed that to 214 single-seat fighters, and then reduced its purchase to 144 fighters in 2012. In April 2018, India withdrew from the FGFA project, believing it did not meet the requirements for stealth technology, combat avionics, radars, and sensors at the time. Indian Air Force Chief Marshal Birendra Singh Dhanoa, in an interview with the official newspaper of the Russian Defense Ministry, Krasnaya Zvezda, Red Star, stated that the Su-57 is not currently being considered for use, but that the aircraft could be evaluated after it enters service with the Russian Air Force. Director General of the United Aircraft Corporation Yuri Slyuser denied earlier reports, saying, "The topic is not closed," and that Russia and India were still discussing the creation of a fifth-generation fighter. However, in October 2019, Indian Air Force Chief RKS Bhadauria stated that the country would not import stealth fighters like the Su-57, and would instead focus on indigenous efforts like the HAL AMCA. Sukhoi has stated that the PAK-FA's main export advantage is its lower cost than current US fifth-generation fighters. Russia reportedly offered the PAK-FA for South Korea's next-generation fighter. South Korea's Defense Acquisition Program Administration, DAPA, stated that the Sukhoi PAK-FA was a candidate for the Republic of Korea Air Force's next-generation fighter, Phase 3FX. However, Sukhoi did not submit a bid by the January 2012 deadline. In 2013, Russia offered Brazil participation and joint production for a next-generation fighter based on the Su-57. Instead of the Russian Su-57 and the French Rafale, Brazil signed an agreement with Sweden's Saab Group to locally produce 36 Gripen E fighters for the Brazilian Air Force.